in Goa. BJP had won both the seats last time. It is likely to lose one and retain
BJP
one.
BJP losing one seat in Goa.
Yeah, and the vote share is 44 to 38.
Correct.
Which is also indicator of the incumbency that is set in, because of which the last assembly elections didn't go as well. In fact, Congress, as per me, had won the mandate, but lost it in the government formation. Mm. They did not form the government in Goa. If they would have formed the government, taken an aggressive approach, probably
BJP should be very worried in Goa, because it's Goa. Your vote share in Goa is going down by that picture. There is a 9.4% decline in vote share compared to 2014.
Goa BJP is likely to lose one seat, retain one seat. And that should concern the BJP, as the anti-incumbency has been set in Goa. You know, as far as the assembly...
Can I put a factoid in? Since 1999, whenever the Goa seats have been split between Congress and BJP, the Congress has won at the center. That's a statistic, of course, but I couldn't help it. Should we go to Gujarat?
So Gujarat, it's a very important state. 26-0 to the BJP was the last time scored. Prime Minister's home state. And the vote share projection right now is 54% for the BJP and 39% for the Congress. So which is pretty much in line with the exit polls in Gujarat that we had done, saying that BJP is losing at the assembly level. But the gap is too big. Still two seats for the Congress, particularly coming
from the North Gujarat region. You're saying 24 seats to the BJP, 2 to the Congress.
Yes.
What does not reflect here, and please be real about it, Abhishek knows Gujarat very, very well. Abhishek would know that last time, Gaurav, please pay attention to this, last time BJP got about 59%.
Yes.
So no, no, they got about 50.
50.1.
No, 59.1 they got. Yeah. BJP, and they were not in alliance.
59%.
Pardon me, Abhishek. Abhishek.
Yeah, in 2014 they got about 60% votes.
About 60% vote. Fine. Arnab, so they have then fallen about 5% now.
Yeah.
Congress.
Yatin Oza, please. We are in Gujarat now. I need your attention,
sir. Can I come in now, Arnab?
No. First, Yatin Oza, please, and I'll put him on with you. Mr. Oza. Okay. Mr. Oza, this is Arnab here. Hello, sir. You're in a moving vehicle.
Yeah, I'm in a moving vehicle. I just landed.
Yeah, thank you so much for joining us straight from your flight.
Yeah, how are you?
I'm very well. Gaurav Bhatia has to debate with you. Gujarat result. Yeah. Gaurav, I'll give Mr. Oza the first word because he was waiting 15 minutes till now and he's in a moving vehicle. Then I'll come to you for a detailed reaction. Mr. Oza, BJP will get 24 of 26 seats. Congress will gain 5%. BJP will lose 5%. But the gap between them is still 16%. So the gap is so much.
Look, Arnab, I don't know about other states. But Gujarat is concerned. You mark my words at this moment. We will meet when the counting takes place in 2019. It is in the worst scenario, 16-10. I am telling you, Surendranagar they are losing. Junagadh they are losing. Amreli they are losing. Jamnagar they are losing, Patan they are losing, Banaskantha, Sabarkantha they are losing, Anand they are losing, Dahod they are losing, and Bardoli. These are the 10 seats. You will now talk again on this issue, we'll meet, we'll discuss other issues, but mark my words, with time, minimum that the Congress is going to get is 10.
Okay, Gaurav Bhatia. You said the same thing, by the way, in the state assembly elections. You said, mark my words. You said, I will leave politics, you never know, come on your channel, I'll not do anything if the BJP forms the government in Gujarat. Making that point,
Arnab.
No, Arnab, said,
Arnab,
BJP
I was coming
will not
to that
comfortably
point.
Form. They will
friend,
have a wafer thin
now,
majority. That is what I had said.
Gaurav.
Now, first of all, Arnab, last time when we were discussing the Gujarat elections, I remember Yatinji used to come and make these tall claims. Even at that time, he said the Congress would form the government. And then after the results, when we met, he smiled. And I think, you know, this time again, his predictions are not his forte. And he's proven wrong on a number of occasions. But let me start by saying that we are talking about the general elections. And one thing should be kept in mind, that India is looking towards Narendra Modi ji for decisive leadership, for the delivery that he has done. And compare this to a Mahathakbandhan that is being formed, where every leader of a regional party or the Congress aspires to be the Prime Minister. Now, speaking for Gujarat, I think even during the assembly elections, when it is not more about the central leadership and Narendra Modi ji, it is about the Chief Minister, we could do so well. And in spite of being in power for 22 years, we formed the government. Now, during the general elections, Narendra Modi ji and Amit Shah, I think the duo magic will work. And I'm sure that we will repeat the feat of getting 26 seats. Second, about Delhi. Delhi, also being a union territory, gets highly influenced by the politics at the center. And we are very hopeful that we'll get 7 seats. Also, the fact that now the votes between the Aam Aadmi Party and the Congress, if you see, their vote percentage have been clear and divided. So it benefits only the BJP, and there is no chance of an alliance. We are in a strong position to take on these two parties in Delhi also. Yeah. And that, I think, clearly shows that it is the BJP versus all the other parties put together without an agenda, without the will to serve the people, only to target Narendra Modi ji on a negative agenda. And people will go for positivity, people will go for welfare, rather than these parties who believe in corruption, in dynastic politics and appeasement politics.